up all friends, you most high friend, boy. Because it's all wicked. You don't want to give what you want. All you only come in the spirit of Cain and not in the spirit of Abel.
I just say that we're not out here really to be right. We're out here to really be right.
This is 1 Samuel chapter 15 verse 22. He says, and Samuel said, had the Lord Yahweh had great delight in burnt offering and sacrifice?
Yeah, had the Lord had great delight in burnt offering and sacrifice? Go ahead.
Obeying the voice of the Lord?
Yeah, as the brother now said, the Lord. That's Nate's song. When we approach you, brothers, where's your fringes? Where's your fringes at? Where's your fringes? That's like a fucking record on loop. You understand? But all of them like dunce bats, just repeating program. You know, just repeating. Nobody ain't thinking that way. The scripture say, hey, Yahweh Shai dead. He's the testator. He's the testator. His blood was shed for the saints.
Yeah, but when that time comes, though, I see them with fringes on them.
This is Proverbs chapter 17, verse 11. An evil man seeketh only rebellion. Chapter 17, verse 11, it says, an evil man seeketh only rebellion. Therefore, a cruel messenger shall be sent against him.
Right, prophets. When we say, hey, Nate, most I can kill you, there is a cruel messenger because at some point, bone shaking because it's true.
And that was the prophet was really about, to never bring more life messages. Message of destruction.
Never
a peaceful sermon.
Your precept, it says what? Rebellion is the sin of witchcraft. Right, go ahead.
He said this 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 22. He said, and Samuel said, and the Lord Yahweh has great delight in burnt offering and sacrifice, as it obeyed the voice of the Lord. Behold, to obey is better than to sacrifice.
To obey is better than to sacrifice. To obey. Because we have people that's what? Because they don't want to obey. Because they don't want to serve great men. The scriptures actually give you instruction on how to serve great men. The apostles and the elders, they are great men. The men before them that taught them, they are great men. You say, hey, rebuke that elder and treat him as a father. You understand? We have to honor these men. Give them double honors. Give double honors to the apostles and elders that rule well.
That's right.
They rule well. The teachers, they never went up. The apostles never tell me to go and eat pork. Yeah, because we no longer they need the law. Go and eat pork. Hey, imagine that. That's the hypocrisy of need. Right? You once told to your congregation and say, hey, we no longer need the law. Go eat pork. Now all you can say is, the law. Where your fringes at? You foolish Galatians, you want to start spiritually and now you end up carnally?
Hey, the scripture says, and you mentioned Galatians. He said, this I would ask you, have you been made perfect by law or by faith?
By faith. And according to the scriptures, you are saved through faith and not of works. Right? The law is of works, the law is of the flesh. Right? Through the law, we know sin. You understand? Through faith and righteousness, we get salvation. And faith in who? Yahweh Shai. You have to know you have faith in. Not the Most High in Christ. The Most High in Christ had what? We had the Crusades. If you call it Most High in Christ, we had the Crusades. What? We had if you call it Allah, we had what is about 3 years ago. We had that big crane falling when they make the pilgrimage to Mecca. Right? They have continual warfare in what? In Afghanistan, in the Middle East, in Syria. Right? So, who is it called now? Chief Agnes. We have famine, we have pestilence across there in India. The Chinese getting liquor from tsunamis all the time, Moabites, the Amorites, Ammonites. You understand? So it's none of these are the names. Yahweh Shai, Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai. Those are the names. Right? Let's hold on. I just had this one on the pause. Go ahead.
This is Hebrews.
This is
Hebrews chapter 9 verse 30.
What?
For if the blood of bulls and of goats and the ashes of an heifer sprinkling the unclean sanctified to the purifying of the flesh, how much more shall the blood of Mashiach?
Those are the offerings. Yeah, these were the offerings that we offered back in the law. Blood of goats, blood of heifers, blood of the lamb, right? Sprinkling on that blood. That's what we used for sanctification back then, right? But it goes on to speak of the new sanctification, because one man's blood was for the nation, was for his sins, for the nation. Right? Go ahead.
How much more shall the blood of Mashiach who through
the blood of who? A Mashiach. His blood was shed for a reason, right? His blood was shed for our sanctification, for our salvation. You understand? That's why we have to believe on him. You have to believe on him. It's all through the scriptures. So these people who preach the law and the fringes and all this carnality, you can see where they're going off. But those who have eyes to see will see. Go ahead.
Who through the Spirit?
Because it's like they're trying to put you out, right? On the cross again. Because when you say the law, it comes like you say, hey, we live in under, you know, we justified by the law. So when you can't keep the law, guess what? Yahweh will come back again to cleanse me again. And so it's not by glory, by grace, by faith. You understand? By faith we are saved through grace. And Nate know that. But Nate, as scripture say, having not the Spirit. So the only thing that he could do is just dress good, look good. Understand? Just look good.
Act the role. Act the role.
Not because somebody says shit to you with a straight face, mean he know he's sin. Nate don't know he's sin.
Not because it's his shit here means that it's a 5-star dinner. It's shit.
You understand?
It's just shit. It's just shit dressed real nice. You understand?
And they could put shit in a box and dress it up and put it up like
that. Put a bow on it.
Look what is there, a nice bow. But it's shit again in a box. It's looking nice.
It's 1 Peter 2 verse 5. It says, you also, as lively stones, are built as a spiritual house. And holy priesthood to offer up spiritual sacrifices.
Right, we as lively stones are built as a spiritual house, right? To offer up lively, what?
Spiritual
sacrifices. This is the sacrifice that we're making here, come out on the highways and byways, right? Come in and see, no matter what season it is, winter, spring, fall, summer, autumn, down here we have two seasons, winter, rainy season and the dry season, right? Hey, a hell of a flood down here. It's hell of a flood. If rain fall now, we can get trapped down here.
Where we used to sacrifice back then? Sheep.
Yeah.
All right. This is Ezekiel 36 verse 37. Thus saith Yahweh, I will yet for this be inquired of the house of Israel to do it for them. I will increase them like men, like a flock.
He will increase them with men. Right, so that's how we build it. That's how this, as I was saying in the beginning, the tree growing. Right, go ahead.
And as the holy flock, as the flock of Jerusalem in a solemn feast, so shall the waste cities be filled with flocks of men. So if we see flocks of the most and not consider sheep, the flocks sacrificed instead, the scriptures say, pleasing unto the Lord is the death of his saints. Alright? So by us coming out here, as in our life, go back to Psalms 15, all right, who shall enter into thy holy tabernacle? We has in the life come, like we, as the scriptures say, we like the lambs to the slaughter. So just coming out here, scriptures say, present your body as a living sacrifice. That is a sacrifice.
That's right.
Coming out here and doing this.
So like the scriptures say, you shall give you fruit, and this fruit shall remain. And we know that fruit comes according to what it is read to amen, right? And they will remain, and they will stand stiff before you are worshiping your child. I mean,
let me show you this, right? Scripture, I can't remember exactly, but I will look for it after the friend in your pocket. They talk about, basically, I think it's like a tree, like if a shady tree, leaves will fall off. But guess what? Just to show you that late men, they can't endure.
Every time you approach one of the eight men, they have not one answer to give you. They don't have, they cannot answer questions. But GMS, the men of GMS in Sioux, is the vanguard, is the knights, knights on the round table. They're always ready to battle, always have an answer according to the scriptures. But the eight men is just like, they're like
empty vessels.
We call this thing like remora. The remora is sucked forward
to the shark. It looks like a shark.
You understand?
It's such a parasite, it looks like a shark. It looks like a smaller version of the shark. But it's not a shark.
The program can say one thing.
Understand? So the car, they could only regurgitate when Nate vomit out, but they could only regurgitate when Nate feed them. But to say, like I say, when you're doing our video, when you're breaking down scriptures, you have to think like if it's a DJ. You know, a DJ will listen one song in this ear, but when he's bringing in the next song, how to be able to, like a perfect blend.
Yeah, get it, match pitch.
Exactly. They don't have a spirit. It's the most high spirit than that. They can't answer questions. Most high Christ. Break that up. Why most high Christ? Where Christ come from? Why the fringes? Aye, hear what is going on. Why the hell are they edging at the back of your heads? Back behind here. And oh, that don't mean to destroy. And your mark underneath your beard. But I don't mean destroy. But it would tell women, leave the husband for a man in truth. And that ain't over. The scriptures talk about overthrow houses. That's not contrary to the scriptures. Come on, man. That was the scriptures said. Scribes and Pharisees, you may clean the outside, but inside is like full of dead men bones.
If they do answer concerning the Most High and Christ, if they answer concerning the name, they're gonna show their hypocrisy, because they're gonna make turn around and say, what? I know the name, yeah, what about Jimmy Oshai? We know the name. It's just that we don't call on the name because the people don't know that name, the people know Christ, and they know the Most High. So that's hypocrisy right there. So they're telling themselves basically.
Hey, they say the Most High regard his word more than his name, right? But did not the Lord say, I do this not for your sake, but for my holy name's sake?
But all glory goes on to Yahweh, but Hashem,
Yahweh, Shai, Khan.
Article and finishes.
Yeah.
How much more, this is Hebrews 9, verse 14. How much more shall the blood of Mashiach, who through the eternal spirit offered himself without spot to power, purge your conscience.
The white man called it a conscience, but it's really a spirit. It's a spirit, go ahead.
From dead works to serve the living power.
Right, from dead works. Dead works, and we're not putting in all our effort into what? Barbecues, cookouts. We're not putting in our effort into what? Into the garments, into cadence. All these different ritualistic things that they do that have nothing to do with salvation. Right?
What? And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament.
Right.
That by means of death, for the redemption of the transgressions that were under the First Testament, they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance.
Right. They which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance. Right? Because many are called and chosen are few. So the righteous are scarcely saved. And we can see why. Because Nate was called. Nate once taught in the name of Yahweh, but Shimei Oshad. Caesarea. Element. Jacanans. And all these other men who were called. Isaac. Right? All these other men who were called. But no, they're on the opposite side of the fence. Preaching us in a bullshit. You understand? Teaching things that not worthy to be taught. They're taking away the flesh from the bones. Because they once put the sinews on, they once put the tendons on, they once put flesh back on the bone. But now they're making it dead once again, those who follow after them. You understand?
Because you're saying that you're offering up a sacrifice, but it's a spiritual sacrifice right there over Hashem Yahushua. He's Exodus 22 verse 20. It says, he that sacrificeth unto any power, save unto Yahweh only, he shall be utterly destroyed. But he had sacrificing unto Christ, born on Christ's flesh. Right? Yeah, he men and them going outside on the highways and the byways saying God and Christ bless. Then he sacrificed, bodily sacrifice, supposed to be to Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai.
Can.
Hey, our piece of paper.